We have a math kit that is geometry. This kit has a wider variety of age levels that it could work for. There are lots of instructions in this kit. So using geo boards and magnet tiles, create various 2- and 3-dimensional shapes, identifying angles of shapes and their properties. There are some instructions for how to play with this tool, a bullseye compass for drawing shapes. There's a handout about shape descriptions to talk about the attributes of different shapes. That's a 2-sided handout. And then also 3-dimensional shapes. What are they called? So a whole bunch of squares put together is a cube. A bunch of triangles put together is a pyramid. So what do you call those shapes? Included in this kit are some geo boards, which we'll be showing you how to play with, and the rubber bands you need in order to play with those. There's a magnet tile with wheels and a box full of magnet tiles. We have the book Squares, Rectangles, and Other Quadrilaterals by David Adler. And for younger children, Bear in a Square by Stella Blackstone. This is a fun one. I like reading this in story time. And here is the bullseye compass that you can use. All right, so another game in the geometry kit are the geo boards. So the first thing that you can do is have the child sort the rubber bands by colors or by sizes. We're going to do by colors. So sort all the different rubber bands by colors. Yeah, good. Now, using the different colors of rubber bands, you can have your child create shapes on the geo board using the rubber bands, using different colors of rubber bands to make different sizes of shapes. So there she's making a circle using a white rubber band on the blue board. If you could use the red rubber band and make a big square and a small square, make a red square on the yellow board. Make a big square. And using red, make a small square. So she has to choose which size rubber band would work best. Now can you make, using a blue rubber band on the yellow board, make a rectangle. A rectangle. Good. Now using the green rubber band on the yellow board, make a triangle. Great. And then what you can do after that is you can use this tool that's included in the kit. It's called a bullseye compass, and you can recreate the shapes formed on the geo board on paper, and the instructions will tell you how to do that. Thank you. This kit has possibility to use it with very young children and also to use it with older children. So one thing we're going to look at is to give children time to play with magnet tiles so you can see how much fun they are to play with. They have little magnets in them so they can be put together in all different piles and shapes.
I have rainbow piles right now.
Okay, that's a fun way to create those, to play with the magnet tiles. Then you can start to talk about the shape names and colors. So can you show me a red square?
Yes, sirree.
Good, and what about a yellow square? And how about a red triangle? And a green triangle? Can you show me a blue and a yellow triangle? Yeah, so just start playing with the pieces, talking about the colors, talking about the shapes. Do you have any rectangles? Uh-uh. Can you make a rectangle?
Yes.
Yeah, by putting two squares together, you make a rectangle. Yeah, good. What about, do you have any other triangles besides the ones that you showed me? So there's a different one, and then do you have another one?
There's three different types of triangles.
Three kinds of triangles. So if children are older, you can start talking about all the different kinds of triangles that there might be, right? Start noticing the attributes of the shapes. So did you notice? Let's look at a big square. Did you know, oh, I can't see it. Did you notice that this big square has four sides? How many corners does it have? Can you count them with your finger? Good,
four
corners. Did you know that every square has four sides and four corners? Can you put a bunch of squares together to make a cube? Can you make a cube? Matches. Oops. That matches. That matches. So this is a cube. What's another way you could create a cube? Nicely done. Can you build a tower?
Yes.
That's an easy way to build a tower. What could you put on the top? And what's fun about magnet tiles, right, is that you can do all kinds of fun things with the edges as well. Very nice. That's a very cool looking tower. Thank you.